triads and triad-based voicings are fantastic as jazz chords. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can start with some of the voicings that you probably already know, turn them into triad voicings, and do a lot of different things. I'm going to go over 5 levels of different ways of comping using this material. And this is something that I use all the time. And if you check out, for instance, the Joe Pass chord solos, then you'll see that he does that as well. My name is Jens Larsen. Learn jazz, make music. First, I'm going to show you a really basic set of chord voicings for take the A train, just the first A part of that. And then I'm going to go over how to convert that into some triad-based voicings and what that opens up for in terms of interesting top note melodies, adding some chromaticism or even some chromatic passing chords. And of course, also some really solid comping rhythms along the way. So we need a C major 7. We can use this one. A D 7. A D minor 7. And then I'm using a G7 flat 9. And then back to C major 7. For the turnaround, I also want to have an A7 flat 9, D minor 7, and then again a G7. And really all we have to do is just throw away the lowest note, the bass note, and then we have triad-based voicings. So there are 2 things you need to realize about these 3-note voicings that we're using now. The first one is that you can actually use different melodies on these voicings. Now we kind of have one finger free because we're not playing the low note, and that means that we can just add another note and change the melody around. We can actually do that for all the voicings, and that's going to give us a lot of options in terms of coming up with some interesting riffs or just changing up the comping a little bit. So for the C major voicing, we have this, and I can also use this A as a melody note, so we have. For the D7, I have this, and then I can have the 13 as well. For the D minor, so we have this one and maybe this one, so also D minor 11. For the G7 flat 9, I can also use the sharp 9, and then A7 flat 9 is of course the same, and then the D minor and the G7 are still the same. The other thing you need to notice is that these voicings are in fact triads, and that's quite logical because if you look at a C major 7, then that's C, E, G, and B. If I leave out the C, so in this case that's the lowest note that I'm leaving out, of course, then I have E, G, and B, so that's an E minor triad. And this is something I'm using throughout these, and they're all in fact triads. So for the first one, E minor triad on the C, D7, so D7 without a D, that's F sharp diminished. Then we get a D minor 7 without D, that's an F major triad. And then we get for the G7, so that's a little bit of a special example here, because here I'm playing a G7 flat 9. And this is not, the triad from the third would be a B diminished triad, but that's not what I have here, because I have B, F, and A flat. And that's an F diminished triad, so that means that I'm using the triad from the seventh of the chord. And that's giving me a 7 flat 9. And then we get the C again, and then for the A7, that's the same idea. So here I'm using the triad, the diminished triad from the seventh, so that's a G diminished triad. And then, of course, D minor, G7. If you play some simple riffs using these 2 melody notes on the A part, then you get something like this. Since all the chords are triads, we can also use inversions of them. And if I use inversions for all the chords and also find some different melody options for those inversions, then I have something like this. In this example, I'm using some other melody notes, and I have to compensate a little bit once in a while. I'm moving this E minor down to this E minor, of course, you recognize that as being this C major 7. And what I'm using here for melody is just using the E and the D. For the D7, I'm doing something a little bit different because I kind of want to have the F sharp in there all the time. That's sort of the clear note for this chord. So what I'm doing is that I'm instead adding some inner voice movement, and I'm doing that by just changing between the A and the G sharp here. So on the D minor 7, so that was this F major triad that becomes this F major triad, and then I'm using this melody. On the G7, I'm actually using this chord voicing and then using just the upper part of that, which is of course a B diminished triad. And then I'm using a flat 13 as well, so I have that melody. And then back to C major 7, the A7 again coming out of this voicing, this basic C sharp diminished, and then the D minor and the G7. In the previous example, I was also playing some melodic movement down inside the chord. So that was on the D7, I had this inner voice movement with the lowest voice moving. And you can do that a lot more in the other chords as well. Another thing that you can also do that works really well is that instead of just going between those two melody notes that we have available, you can also move chromatically in between them and then just keep the chord under it like this. And that's something that I'm also using a lot in the next example. So the first part of this is really straightforward. It's just using the two melody notes on the E minor triad like in the beginning. So then we get some inner voice movement where I'm starting with the E minor triad for my C major voicing here. And then I'm going from the seventh, so the B, down to the A. But I'm using a chromatic passing note for that, like this. And a similar idea, but then in the top note melody on the D7. And then going down to the inversion, because of course, I can also on the chord move between inversions and that way move around the neck. And then again the variation where I'm using the sharp 11 here, going to D minor 7. On the G7, again a chromatic melody to C major. And then I'm using, this time on the D7, I'm using an inversion of the C sharp diminished. So this one, going to D minor, and then G7. The next example is exploring some of the inner voices and also some chromaticism in the inner voices a bit more, but then it's also starting to work with altering some of the lower voices in the triad, and that's really creating some more modern sounding jazz chord voicings with some minor second intervals lower in the chord. On the C major 7, I'm really just using this E minor triad as the voicing, so again just coming out of this chord. But then now I'm moving the 7th, that's the middle voice, down to the 6th. And in the second bar I'm just playing a riff, but really only in the inner voice movement. So the E stays as a static melody note, and then I have the movement in the middle voice. On the D7, it's still all coming out of this, which is of course an F sharp diminished triad. And then first with the sharp 11, and then moving all the way up to the 13 here. So that's really just using the same idea that I did in the beginning. So we have this F sharp diminished, and then I can use the 13 instead of the 5th. And of course we can do that here as well. And that's the 5th, so we add the 13 like this. On the D minor 7, just changing the top note melody. And then on the G7, it's coming out of this B diminished triad, so it's really just an inversion of this rootless version here, and then with a 13 instead of the 5th, so it's similar to the D7, resolving that down, and then we get basic C major 7. On the A7, I'm playing this, which is like a G diminished, so that's the diminished triad from the 7th. And on the D minor, just using first this and then back to this B diminished on the G7. As you can see, you can take these principles really far and get some really modern sounding voicings, and you get a lot of flexibility when you're working with this. And you can use a lot of the same principles on drop two voicings. And if you want to check out a video where I'm working with this on Satin Doll, another Ellington classic, then check out this video where I'm going over 5 levels of drop two comping and also really mixing in some triad voicings along the way on Satin Doll.